share with your friends. For joining me, you are now officially inside with Noni Ayana, and tonight I'm going to talk about, or the subject's title is, your man is your son and you have become his mother. Let me tell you the inspiration behind this particular topic for tonight, because I am literally fed up. And some of these women, they can't help it. They can't help. Well, actually, they can. Actually, you can help if you're in a bad relationship. You can. Some people are just more prone to highly dysfunctional relationships. And, you know, sometimes it's just hard to break away from that routine. I get it. You know, as my dad used to say, your picker is off. That's what he used to tell me. Because I was just dating whoever. I didn't have no plan. I was just, you know, I dated whoever I liked. There was no agenda. There was no plan. Because for a long time, I didn't want to get married. So I was like, you know, I'm not really trying to get a husband, you know, which a lot of older men can't understand why a woman wouldn't want to be married, right? But anyway, that's besides the point. The point is that there are so many women out here that date these fixer-uppers, okay? These men out here, and they, you know, they might really be good men. There's a good man out there for everybody. Now, good man is relative, okay? So, you know, they get these particular brothers, or, you know, when I say brothers, I'm not necessarily talking about black men. I'm just talking about men in general. But they date these brothers, and, you know, they have to do all these, they're what I call fixer-uppers, right? So he may not have it all together. You see all this awesome potential in him. And so you're like, okay, I can work with this. I can, you know, he may not have this, he may not have that, but he's a good man. You know, I hear that a lot. He's a good man. Okay, I get it. It's the prisons are filled up. They are full of good men. Like, straight up. So a lot of women out there that think those men are good, even though they broke the law. You know, the mamas are, that's, he ain't trying to hurt nobody. Meanwhile, he, you know what I'm saying, doing the most illegal stuff you can think of. So these women, they date these men, right? And, you know, they feel like, okay, I can just, he's pretty much good. So all I got to do is kind of fix him up, straighten him up, clean him up a little bit, and he'll be all right. He'll be perfect for me, is what I get. Okay. in a minute, I'm going to let you know what I mean by, when I talk about the mom, what the role of the mother has to do with this. And you'll see what I'm talking about in a minute. Okay. Because there is, if anyone knows, there's a special bond between a mother and her son. Like it's a bond like no other, like a lot of daddy's girl feel about their father, right? It is a bond that is very special and unique to mothers and sons. Okay. I get that. Right. And I actually wrote an article about this in my blog. So if go to insidewithnoniayana.com, you can catch the article that I wrote for this particular blog, right? For this particular topic, when it comes to the mother-son relationship and how it affects romantic relationships, okay? So, there's a special bond between the mother and son, and sometimes it can influence how a man behaves in a relationship. Now, if I have some men listening, or if I have some brothers watching on Periscope, correct me if I'm wrong. Ladies, agree if I'm right. But I tend to find, and I'm just a sexologist, right? I just, you know, I ask questions. I do a lot of research. I read a lot of peer-reviewed articles, and I get, you know, and people come to me and tell me their stories. So, you know, it's unlike the average person, I am just inundated with, you know, great and accurate, real information. So I'm pulling my conclusions from that, okay? As a professional and as a person, as an individual. Right. So what I'm saying is the mother-son relationship, okay, directly affects how he relates to women. It does. Why? Because she is the first example of what it is to interact with the opposite gender, with women. She's the first example of that. So he carries this into his romantic relationships. Logical. Not a whole lot of science behind that, okay? Or, you know, just it's very logical and it makes a lot of sense is what I'm saying. So, now, when it comes to, what I'm going to do is I'm going to list some things, because I have a list here, and those who are watching me on Periscope, I'm going to read through this list. I'm going to list characteristics that a mother has, or things or behaviors that she shows towards her son that are very similar to women in relationships who have similarly begin to act like his mother. I'm going to go down the list. I'm just going to go down the list. Okay. And I want you to see the striking resemblance between his mother, what the mother does, and how a woman acts towards her male mate. Okay. That's all I'm saying. So just listen carefully. And those who are on Periscope, if you want to pitch in to some similarities, feel free to type those in, okay? So now, number one, when it comes between mother and son, okay, he pretty much can fuck up and she will still love him, right? He can completely fuck up and she'll just be like, oh, that's my baby. He don't mean to hurt nobody. He's a good boy. He just need a little and she'll go into what he need, right? Mama, ladies, do you find yourself talking this way about your man? I'm just saying. Number two, okay. Well, not number two, because I'm not going to keep up with the numbers. But the next one, mama can be kind of controlling, right? She want to know pretty much, you know, what he's doing. I want to keep an eye on him, because this is what mothers do. This is what mothers do. Okay? She wants to control him. She, you know, where you at? What you doing? You gonna come by? I need to see you. Blah, 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 blah. We talking about grown sons, okay? And well, some of it can relate to younger sons, but you'll still get the picture. All right? So the mom can be controlling. Ladies, the similarities. We're talking about the similarities here. Are you controlling? Right? Because I know some of you all need the passcode to his phone. You want to know where he's going, what time he's coming back. Some men have curfews, that sort of thing. I'm really not a fan of the whole curfew thing. If there's a mutual respect, I really shouldn't have to give you a curfew. And number one, if there's a mutual respect and I trust you, if I trust you, I trust you. Okay. If I don't, I'm gonna be like, I don't really trust you. And if I don't really trust him in that way, I probably shouldn't be with him. That's how I feel about that. Okay. So, mama tries to control him. We're looking at the similarities. Are you trying to control your man? Do you need to know where he is at all times? Do you control the type of people he hang out with? That sort of thing. Can he not like a woman's picture on social media? Can he not just click like on that? He can't do that. Stuff like that. You know, just to me, that's kind of petty, but this is what women do. That's just my personal opinion. You know, stuff like that. Controlling, micromanaging. Every little thing he does, you on top of it. Because you feel like it won't get done properly or it won't be right unless you make sure he does it right, right? So what grown man wants that? Well, I mean, that's his mama is what I'm trying to tell you. That's his mama. He trying to get away from her. He left the house to get away from her, okay? If he loved home so much, he stay there. You got some brothers that do. On to the next one. Mom can sometimes nag, right? He's really not listening to her. Moms nag. They nag daughters too. Moms can be, they can nag until it get on your nerves, right? But he knows what to say and what to do to put a smile back on her face because, you know, he know she won't be mad long. Just nag. Complaining about little shit. You know what I'm saying? He's really not paying any attention because that's how men are. They don't pay attention to like nagging and whining and complaining. What they hear is the tone. They hear the tone and they understand that the nagging is frustrating the hell out of them, but they're not really hearing what you say. Do you understand what I'm saying, ladies? That's mama. Mama can go on and on and on. He ain't heard a word she said. He hasn't heard a word she said. This is mother. Do you want to be his mother? Trust me, you don't. You don't. Okay? What's the next one? Let me see here. The next one. She quickly gets him out of trouble. She's the rescuer. We got a lot of people, you know, that's kind of like a particular type of attachment is the rescuer, the one who wants to save everyone. But the mother and her son, that's a special relationship. So she is quick to save her son. Anytime he's in trouble, she's there. And when she saves him, she scolds him, right? So my thing is this. Do you quickly get him out of trouble? Are you, anytime he messes up, anytime he does something wrong, anytime, any type of situation where he finds himself in some deep shit, are you getting him out of that? With no hesitation. That's mom. Mom, you don't want to be mom, is what I'm saying. All throughout this show, I'm going to tell you, you don't want to be the mother. There is a difference between being his partner and being his mother. And you would want to be his partner because if you turn into his mother, you're going to be taking care of him for the rest of his life. And what grown woman wants to take care of a grown ass man is all I'm saying. All right. So the rescuer, she's the rescuer. How about, and again, those on Periscope, if you are a man and you're listening, and you agree or don't agree, or if I'm making sense, please let me know. I need some confirmation. So anyway, how about this? Some mothers expect everyone else to accommodate his needs just as she does, right? So the mom, especially if you're the girlfriend, she want to know, you know, you ain't fixing my son a plate. You not making sure he this, making sure he that. You know, everybody needs to accommodate him the way she accommodates him. Mom. That's mom. Right? Ain't no love like mama's love, for real. But Ladies, you have to learn to stay in your lane. Mama has a lane, you have a lane. When you start behaving like his mother, you have stepped out of your lane and now you have responsibilities that you really don't want. But us women, we get caught up in being depended on and being nurturing and being the mothers, because that's what we do. We are made to be, our bodies are made to be mothers. I get it. But at the same time, this is a separate identity, and you have to learn how to shift from one identity to the next, okay? Without them intertwining, all right? So mom quickly, expects everyone to accommodate his needs just as she does. All right, mom makes excuses for his shortfalls, right? So she is like, you know, he's just having a bad time, or he's just going through something right now, or he really could finish college, but you know, he needs his space. He needs time to think about what he really wants to do. She will come up with every excuse in the world. And then, to be honest with you, behind your back, she rolling her eyes at you. Like, really, she's like, oh my God, I wish he'd get it together. But in front of you, she's like, oh, he's just, you know, when she refers to you, you know, talking to other people. So are you doing that, ladies? Are you making excuses for his shortfalls? Because my thing is this, why even make the excuse? Why even, they don't even have to know that he's having issues, to be honest with you. You don't even have to discuss that. But some women get caught up in, I need to defend him mode. When you have to defend your man, okay? If you have to defend him, that's not a good sign, because that means you feel like you have to compensate for where he lacks. But if he is truly a person who respects you and you respect him, and he is considerate of you and you are considerate of him, and you all work together as a partnership, he will do what he can to make things right. And you won't feel like you have to defend him, to be honest with you. That's all I'm saying. Mom scolds him in public. Here's the thing, ladies. I think it's a huge no-no to try to scold your man in public, especially when it comes to, like, if he's looking at another woman or something like that. Like, if you scold him in public, it's almost like your mama came down to your school and said, I'm gonna whoop your ass in front of the whole class. That's very much a mama thing. Why would you do that? That is so emasculating. As a man, I'd be pissed. And I would not talk to you. I wouldn't have nothing to do with you if you ever, if I was a man, if you ever did that in front of my people, in front of my boys, or whatever. Like, really? Like, who are you? That's a mama thing. Again, we don't want to be mom. We want to be his partner, okay? When you become his partner, he treats you differently. He treats you with respect. He treats you as a separate person than his mother. Then he has different expectations of you versus the expectations of his mother, okay? That's all I'm saying. Mom allows him to use her. She is the enabler. He will use her over and over again for money, for resources, for a place to stay. I mean, he will use her over and over again. And she will allow it to happen, because she feels as though, as his mother, she is, you know, she's obligated to do so. She doesn't understand the difference between being used, okay, and being someone he can, that will assist him, that will help him, aid him, not necessarily be used by him. You know what I'm saying? There's a difference in helping, assisting, right? So as a woman, and let me tell you, I'm not just coming up with this stuff off the top of my head. I've been there. I have been there where I looked up and was like, this dude, he done became my son. Straight up. One particular relationship I had, and I'll get back to the list. One particular relationship I had. Oh, man. This brother was the worst. It was to the point, as a boyfriend, he's a good guy. But as a boyfriend, He was just the worst. He was the worst boyfriend I ever had. He was the worst boyfriend I ever had. Okay? It's to the point where just the memory of it, you know, gives me like straight just heart palpitations. Because dude was not, he was like a son. And the way he was like a son was that he was so dependent on me. Here's what made him even more, this is what made me son him even more. The fact that he knew that I had my hands full. He knew that I was a single parent. He knew that I was in school. He knew I had a lot of responsibilities. He knew that I was an entrepreneur, that I had a lot of stuff going on. But he loaded me up with responsibility. That's the problem. Knowing that, and that's the issue with the strong black woman thing. Okay? Because a lot of black men assume that you can handle all your shit and all they shit at the same time too. That's the problem. That is the problem. And black women feel like, oh, I can handle it. We juggle. We juggle school. We juggle marriage. We juggle relationships. We juggle bullshit at the job and people we don't like. We juggle badass kids. We juggle all this stuff. Okay? In church. We juggle all that, right? And we are literally killing ourselves trying to be this strong black woman. We're doing it. And this has a lot to do with the topic, because when you are in a relationship where the man has literally become your son and he don't even see it. He don't even see it. He's so into that mother-son zone that he doesn't even recognize the fact of, he doesn't even recognize what he's doing. He recognizes how he's using you, but he does not care how it affects you as a woman. He doesn't care how it affects your life, if it's stressing you out. Cause black women, we don't really show stress. We kind of keep that in. So on the outside, it looks like we holding it all together, but really we're hurting, crying in the dark. We can't eat, or we're overeating. You know what I'm saying? These are the issues that women have to deal with. And I'm saying, wake the fuck up, wake up. He's your son. He's not your man. He's your son. He's not your partner, rather. He needs to be your partner. That's all I'm saying. But that boyfriend that I was talking about, the worst one in my entire boyfriend history, he's doing well. He's doing well. He's doing good now. And that's great for him. But when we were together, he wasn't worth shit. That's all I'm saying. All he did was make my life. He didn't add anything positive to my life. He was taking all of the energy out of me. He was draining me. I had nothing left. And I was so into wishing he was this guy. I had made up this image of my head in my head as to what I wanted him to be. And I was so into trying to help him become the man that I wanted him to be that I wouldn't fully recognize who he really was. That was the problem. And that's the problem with fixer-uppers. That's the problem with men who practically become your son, because you get so caught up in the nurturing aspect. You get so caught up in trying to make sure he's okay. You get so caught up in being loyal. We get a lot of that, especially among black women. We get caught up in, I got to be the ride or die. Fuck that. If it's killing you on the inside, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. He doesn't care. He does not care. That brother that I was with, he didn't care. He didn't care. And then, you know what's funny? He had the nerve to leave me. Like, he broke up with me. And you know, here's the thing. When he broke up with me, I was actually distraught. I mean, I was fucking terrified. I was so upset. And I was so upset. Here's what's funny. I was so upset about him breaking up. He wasn't worth, really. He didn't add any positivity to my life or my situation, okay? I was struggling. I was struggling financially. He wasn't helping pay for nothing, cover nothing. You know what I'm saying? There was a time when he stayed with me. He didn't pay for shit. And I allowed it. Sometimes, ladies, when you're in this position, you have to practice some accountability, you know? And I allowed it. And I had to look back at that situation and be like, what the fuck was I thinking? I was desperate in a lot of ways, and I was lonely. So here's the thing. Okay, so when I was with him and I was distraught and crying and all upset, I was so into my episode of anger and of feeling abandoned and rejected. I was so caught up in my episode that I literally had a moment of clarity. And I was literally asking myself, while I was crying, I literally asked myself, why the hell am I crying? I don't even want this fool. He really could leave. He doing me a favor. These are the thoughts that are going through my head. But you know, I had to finish the scene out because I was still concerned about his ego. And he felt so big and bad leaving me. You know, a lot of times we don't want people to break up with us. We want to break up with them first, especially if you're the better partner. How the hell you gonna leave me? But he did. And I am thankful. Okay? I am thankful. Because I probably still would have been caught up in that food. Well, I don't know if I still would have been caught up in it, because I'm really a different woman now than I was at that point. I've grown. I will have to admit that I've grown. But I would have probably stayed in that dysfunctional relationship even longer. Because I was so caught up. And you know, the sex was great. You know, for some reason, brothers like that. Brothers, you have the son. They always got good dick. I don't understand that. What is that about? The brothers who can offer the least can always offer the most sexually. That's all they got. That's all they got. You know, so they just slang dick everywhere, right? They just slang it, and that's all they got. So it's like, hell, I think what it is that they understand that their lack of manhood is there. So I think they try to pretty much use sex as a way to like reaffirm their manhood. I really do think that's what that is. Cause you got a lot of the brothers that can't give you shit any other way. They are totally like, they're great with sex. Great. And, so, and a lot of times have the biggest dick. I don't know. Anyway, back to my list. So that's my little story about my, I wonder if he ever watched this. Would he even realize that I was talking about him? That's what would be interesting. Anyway, back to the list. You allow him to overwhelm you with his wants and needs. Really, it's very similar to what I was talking about with my ex. I totally allowed him to overwhelm me with all his stuff. Okay? All his stuff. There was actually a point where he didn't have a car at the time, like a point in the relationship where he didn't have a car. And this brother would get mad at me because I was going to use my car, and he had already made plans for my car. So he couldn't use it, right? So he would be pissed that he couldn't use my car that he made plans for, even though it was my car. What in the hell? I don't even understand that. Anyway, I really hope that some guys watch this, because I'm going to post this on my YouTube page, but I hope some guys are listening. Like, I want you to realize what you are doing. Like, what the hell? I could not believe he did that. How you gonna get mad? Here's another thing he would do, right? Because he didn't have a car, he was using the transit system, okay? So, there will be times where I'm literally walking out of the house. I got all kind of shit in my hands. I'm rushing to the door. I'm trying to get stuff done. This brother would ask me to take him to the train station as I'm walking out of the door. Okay? And it wouldn't be a train station that was close by. No. He had to pick one that was 30 minutes away. I'm like, really? So you don't care if I'm late? Like, I'm already, you know, close to being late. I'm like, if I leave now, I'll be right on time. But your ass gonna ask for a ride that take 30 minutes. Hold up. Whew. I still got some unresolved feelings about that, because clearly he was very inconsiderate. Whew. And when you have a male partner, okay, that you have sunned, a lot of times they are totally inconsiderate. This is what they do, okay? Are you allowing him to overwhelm you with his wants and needs? And then the next one, mama can handle anything. Going back to the strong black woman myth, mama can handle it all. So when she comes home and cook and blah, 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 I can have her, she can wash my clothes. She can cook my meal for me too. She can make sure that she irons my clothes for tomorrow. I mean, you know what I'm saying? He'll add all that stuff. He ain't doing shit, by the way. He laid up. Back to my ex. I come to the house. My kitchen is jacked up. When I say jacked up, I mean it's jacked up. It's chicken skin all on the oven and spices and shit sprayed all over the oven. And the sink, dishes in the sink. I'm talking about the sink. The kitchen is terrible. Okay, it looked like five or six top chefs went in there and prepared a five-course meal. He ain't cooking nothing but chicken and rice, okay? Here's the thing. When I get into the house, he's sitting at the computer. You couldn't clean up the kitchen? I don't have time. You ain't got time. Hold, wait a minute. You got time to jack the kitchen up. You got time to eat and be on your laptop. But you don't have time to clean it up. Oh, Lord. These are the things your child does. A grown-ass man will be considerate. He will understand that when you come home, you are tired. You have things that you are doing. If you're a single parent, he understands you already have a lot of responsibility on your hands. So what will he do? He will clean the kitchen before you even get in the house. It will look like he never cooked. This is what a considerate partner does. But your son, you have become his mother. Sons don't do that. Sons don't clean up. They let mama do it. So do you see where I'm going with this? Do you see the similarities? Okay? Your man is your son and you have become his mother. Okay? That's all I'm saying. The next one. Although he causes you anxiety, you never tell him because you don't want him to feel abandoned or rejected. As a mother, that's one of the worst things you want your son to feel. Okay? Mothers will damn near sacrifice themselves for their children. Okay, so back to being a partner. Are you doing this? Okay? Are you allowing him to worry you? Are you allowing yourself to become anxious? Are you stressed out? Okay? All of these things are happening because he really is not thinking of you. He really is not being a partner. There's no give and take. He is only taking. That's the issue, ladies. And there was a conversation I was having on Facebook. I wonder if I can find it. I want to read her post. I've got to be able to find this post. Let me see if I can find it. I won't reveal her name because I don't want to put her out like that. But her situation is very similar to a lot of women that are in these relationships and just don't want to go. For some reason, they keep saying, he's a good man. He's a good man. He's a good man. I'm like, how? He is cheating on you left and right. He don't even like your kids. What is that? How is he a good man? Well, he pays for everything. Okay, well, shit. I mean, you can get a job and do that. Hold up, I've got to find this freaking post. Where the crap is it? Otherwise, I just have to like, damn. Where is this freaking post? Let me see. I'm gonna find it because I have got to read. Here we go. I have found the post. Now, this lady, I'm not gonna read it verbatim because I don't want to put her out there, but her post pretty much was describing her. She's married, okay, for many years. They have children, okay? He is cheating and has been cheating since day one, okay? The kids love him. I had a boyfriend who my daughter adored. We could not get along for shit, but she loves him. What is that about? We can't get along, but the kids love him. Anyway, and I'm going to show you how that affects how women think when it comes to whether I should stay with this partner or not. So they're married. She has kids. They're not his kids. I think, oh, okay. They do share children. Excuse me. I was reading that wrong. They do share children. Okay. But lately, he wants to turn everything into an argument or a fight. And then he kind of like leaves the house and doesn't show up for a long period of time. Right. But he's the sole provider of the household. And her thing is, this is tearing me apart. Totally get it. So he's cheating. There's no real communication going on with them. He, although he is the provider of the home, how does that make, you know, some women, that's all they need, and they, and he's a real man if he just takes care of the house. But my thing is this, is he really? He is running to women, other women, any chance he gets. Something is going on at the house. She didn't really get into much of that. A lot of the information that she gave was really about him more so than her, which leads me to a lot of questions as well. But when you have situations like this where men have no concern for who you are, and there was what I said to her was, there is no mutual respect, out of one of the many things I said to her. But there is no mutual respect between the two of you. He doesn't care. He's literally going to former girlfriends, their homes, and he's sitting back and having drinks and all that with them. Like, would you be cool with that? I just need to know. Somebody tell me. Would you be cool for your man to go sit at his ex-girlfriend's house, drink liquor, and be like, nothing's going on? Would you believe him? That's all I'm saying. The issue with this young woman, and the issue with a lot of women that are in these relationships, are boundaries. There are none. He's doing whatever the hell he wants to do. And, you know, women say, how can I make him stop? How can he see that I'm the one? I'm the best woman for him. How can he not see this? I love him. He is everything to me. He doesn't see that he's everything to me. Okay? Exactly, Kitty. Right. He can go over there and stay the hell over there. Exactly. Bye. Exactly. Take your ass over there. That's where you want to be. Stay over there. But here's the problem. He paying for everything. So, you know, she can't. There has to be a better way for her to play that, even though he's paying for everything. But I think she's so into what he could be, because she mentioned a lot of things about he could be this, he's very that, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, yeah, but the whole relationship is based on a lie, because he's not even at home half the time. You know what I'm saying? He's doing whatever the hell he wants to do. Once again, there's no mutual respect. I'm gonna need that in my relationship. I can't have you. Like, there needs to be some boundaries set where you say, okay, this is what we're going to do. This is what I expect out of you. This is what you expect out of me. But if he doesn't respect you from the beginning, then the likelihood of you getting that throughout the relationship is very slim. Brothers like that usually don't change. Not for that particular partner in the, you know, at least. What'll happen is they'll break up. He'll realize how shitty he was, and then he'll be awesome for the next woman. That's usually how it happens. But my thing is this, I was telling her, you have no boundaries. She was like, how can I make him change? You can't make him change. He is who he is. And your behavior has pretty much shown him that you accept it, that you are willing to accept all the bullshit he puts on your plate. Because all you do is turn the other cheek. You don't want to say anything that's going to anger him or cause any conflict, because you are in a delicate position, because he's the sole provider of the home. So that's my thing. My thing would be, first of all, put yourself in a more self-sufficient position so you won't be dependent on somebody like that. That's my thing. Like me, I tell her, she need to go. The problem comes from women who have to depend on men and get it together. Exactly. Exactly. You should never put yourself in a position where you're solely dependent on your partner. Like, really. Always be self-sufficient enough where if anything go down, at least you'll be able to take care of yourself and your kids if you have any. But when it's to the point where your every move is based on what he says and does. And that's another thing. Like, do you understand the type of power play, the type of power that you're giving your partner when you do that? When you say, I'll give all my power away and I'm going to let you control everything. That's pretty much what she says in this relationship. And he's like, cool, you ain't going nowhere anyway. So I'm going to do what I want to do. So I'm going to go over here to my ex-girlfriend's house, because I know you ain't going to say shit. I take care of the house. So I'm going to go do what I do with my ex, and we're going to have a good time. And when I feel like coming home, I'm going to come home. That's how he sounds to me. I couldn't be in a relationship with like that. Not at all. See, and I can tell you that now as someone who's been through that, okay? that relationship, how long were we together, me and my, I think we were together maybe like a year and a half, but he didn't start showing his ass until I was finally financially capable to do some things, and that's when he became super dependent on me. That's when that happened. I'm like, hold up, you ain't need no rides and all this beforehand? What happened? Anyway, so those are my things. So I want you all to really consider the similarities that I just described. And if you are doing any of those things, congratulations, you have become his mother. But guess what? You ain't his mama. You are a grown ass woman with shit to do. You ain't got time to be raising somebody grown ass son. Okay? Let his mama do that. If he is causing you anxiety and stress, he should know. Okay? Or you should know. Not only should he know, but a partner would want to do what it takes to relieve the stress, because that's what partners do. Partners work together for the betterment of the partnership. If one is hurting, both are hurting. If one is stressed, both are stressed. If one is in pain, both are in pain. First thing you want to do when you become of age is leave the house. For boys, he wants the opportunity to be the man he is meant to be. But if you are becoming his mother, he has not left the house. Do you see what I'm saying? Mentally, he hasn't left the house. He is still with mama. You, because you are providing all those things a mother would provide. You know why some men find it difficult to view his wife as sexy, but will have an affair or cheat with someone he would never consider marrying? Because he associates wifehood with motherhood. That's why he can shove his penis in the mouth of a woman and totally have no respect for her, because she has not been categorized with the women he highly respects. Right? Mama. Except you kind of like as a partner, you don't get no respect, because you're kind of like you're really not the mom, but you provide motherly things. So it's kind of like the half-assed way. That's why he's all like, oh, she ain't really, I love her, I'll do these things for her. I won't totally go off the deep end, but at the same time, she's not gonna get all of me. That's kind of how he's playing it. Especially the guy in that story. In a partnership, you discuss, you listen, you communicate, you have conversations. Both are contributors in the relationship. As a son, you don't really have to contribute because mom is the caretaker. If you're the mom and he feels like the son, because he's pretty much totally emasculated at this point. He may not even say it out loud or recognize it, but he's totally emasculated at that point. Okay? Because you have mothered him so. You've pretty much just mothered his manhood away, okay? If this is the case, he really doesn't feel like he's contributing in that way. You know what I'm saying? Now, the dude, I think he's kind of halfway saving his manhood because he's paying for everything. And, you know, that's kind of like how society is. If you're the man and you're paying for everything, then that makes you a man. So he's kind of saving himself in that regard. However, I really wonder what's going on with her and how she treats him. I wonder if that has anything to do with why he doesn't come home, even though I don't justify any man doing some of the things that she says he's doing. But I also am curious about her side of the story. So I really can't respond to her stuff the way I really want to, because I don't know her side. I just know what she was saying about him. Okay. And in these type of situations, you know, I see women complain about the brother and all that, but at the same time, I'm like, okay, but meanwhile, you doing some other shit. Anyway, so this type of relationship where he is not contributing is not a reciprocal relationship. She takes care of you, but you don't take care of her. So two important words that I want you to remember, if nothing else, mutual respect. Okay? Now, let's talk about you, the woman. Ask yourself, why are you in this relationship? Why are you in this relationship? Make a list. Let's list all the good things about this person, about the man. And I mean the good things this person is doing, like genuinely doing, not the things you think he'll be good at. Like, don't put your wish list. Create a list of that. Because I think I asked that young lady, I was like, why are you staying in this relationship? Like, why are you staying? She can never really give me a full detailed answer. The recurring answer she gave me was the fact that he paid for everything. That was one of her key things, that he paid for everything and that he had a good relationship with the kids and the kids didn't want to see them split up. That was her thing. So part of her reason for staying was for the children, which I don't agree with at all. Do not stay for the children. The marriage is for you. It is not for the kids. If you are unhappy in your marriage, they will see it and they will see the dysfunction. And this is the example you will be providing for them before they go out into the world and develop their own relationships. Okay, because I let her know that there are some messages that are seen and not heard. You need to remember that. All right. So when you make this list of all the things that your partner really is doing that's good stuff, okay, then you make the list of all the things that he is not doing, things that you want that he is not doing. Now, I did that for my ex, for the ex that I was just talking about. I did that for him. The side of the things that I wish he would be or that he's not, that side was hella long. And on the pros as to why I should be with him, it was very short. And I realized that I was staying with him for superficial reasons. And much of it had to do with me just wanting to be with someone. Me just wanting to be able to say, I got a man. And you have a lot of women out there that are like that. And that's why they're with these type of guys. Because they really just want to be able to say, I have a man. They want to be able to go to an event with their boyfriend and be with the other couples. Because we are in a very coupled society. Everybody got somebody. I get it. But at the same time, we have women who are literally risking their sanity to meet the status quo. So when you make your list, compare the two sides, okay? Are you allowing him to be the man in the relationship is another question that I have. What does this mean? Well, some would say, I'm gonna need him to step up and be a man. Okay, well, stop picking boys to be your partner and start choosing men, and you may not have that problem anymore. That could be it too. So allowing him to be the man, what does this include? No micromanaging, don't micromanage your man. Like, really? We going back to the mama behavior. Let him do what he gonna do. Now, if he does a lot of stupid shit, then you just don't need to be with a man who tends to do stupid shit. Or you need to have some effective communication going on there where you feel like you all can really talk and discuss, and you will discuss in a way that both people are listening and providing real helpful information in the discussion. Okay. When you get to that point, that's good, because you know he's listening and he's more likely to not only listen, but apply what you've said. But that's a certain type of guy. If you don't have that guy, then you might need to rethink being with him. Assist, but not enable. So you can assist, you can help. We got people that we help all the time. People help people. It happens. But when it comes to the point where you are constantly bailing him out of situations, okay, and not allowing him to hold himself accountable or take responsibility for his actions, you're going back to that mom behavior again, okay? Let him make mistakes. Resolve the mistake. Learn from the mistake. Let him make mistakes. If he get caught up in some shit, you be like, I'm here for you. I can support you, but I'm gonna need you to have to handle that on your own. You got to handle that on your own. Ain't nothing I can do about that. I can tell you how I feel about it. I can tell you where I think you should improve. I can tell you how this hurts our relationship, how I have certain expectations of you, and I feel that you are a better person, and I feel like, this is not you and that you might be going through a tough time. Let's talk about that. Let's see if we can come to some sort of resolution as to how I can help you be that better person. Like, that sort of discussion. Not allowing him to take responsibility for his actions, period. Like, he need to be able to say, I fucked up. He need to be able to say that. And he needs to be able to own it. And you need to be able to let him say that. Like, don't make excuses for his fuck ups. Like, let him live it. Let him go through it. Let him experience it. Let him learn from it. And let him apply it to his life. Okay? Do not attempt to control his every move. Once again, we don't want to do that. Ask him about his whereabouts, where you going. You got some brothers that have to like ask for permission for stuff. Can I go out with blah, 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 blah. Here's an interesting thing. Like, so say for instance, for example, I have a male friend, right? And he was in town. We haven't seen each other in a while. So he texts me saying, you know, when can we meet? I'm like, ooh, I got a lot of stuff going on, blah, blah, blah. But when he texts me, he was pretty much, he said, when can you get away from the mister, is what he said. And I was like, wow, that's interesting that he said that. Because to me, it means, why would I want to get away from him? If you're with somebody, it shouldn't be a matter of getting away from that person. And it just goes to show how relationships are viewed and how women are viewed and how men view women in relationships as though it's some kind of bondage, you know, the bondage that you don't want. It's some kind of like, entrapment. Like, your relationship should not be viewed in that way. So I was like, ooh, that question is very boyfriend-ish, very, social ideology of relationships. I didn't really care for how it was worded. I know he didn't mean nothing by it, but I was just like, I would never want to get away from my mister, is how he said it. If you're in a relationship, there should be a mutual understanding of the type of friendships that you have and you know what I'm saying? You should be able to discuss that with your partner and it not be a huge issue because you all know how to effectively communicate with each other, okay? But don't, you know, trying to control him, he's just really going to, he's going to act like a son. You know how sons do? They just like have tantrums. They have these fits, right? And they have these tantrums and they get upset and they storm out and then they don't come back until late that night. And then you ask him where he's been and he's like, why you want to know? And then y'all got this argument. Fuck all that. I ain't got time for that. You know what I'm saying? I don't have time for that. You got grown ass people with responsibilities. Pick responsible people. Pick people who are going to be respectful of you and your time and your home. You know what I'm saying? You have some brothers out there that respect their partners so much that even if they do go out, they wouldn't come in at a super late time because they respect their partners too much to do that. Do you see what I'm saying? Like, there's a difference. It's like, I love her. I want to be with her. I enjoy being with her. I don't want to do anything that I feel could cause conflict in our relationship. Bam. You gotta, and there's some brothers that think like that. No lie. It's some that do, but it's definitely some that don't. Those are the ones we don't want to be with. They got to learn. This is not how you treat women. Women, we, you know, that's what they mean by raising the standards. Okay. When you accept anything, when you have a majority of the women, especially in Atlanta, where they just take anything the men give, then that, you know what I'm saying? Like they say, it decreases our value. They don't expect to really do a whole lot because they've been getting away with it so long. So when they finally get with a woman who has boundaries, who has standards, they call her a bitch. They call her the bitch, right? This is what happens. Because they, you know, so many women have been doing some bullshit for so long. Anyway, hold him accountable. That's allowing him to be the man. Hold him accountable. Allow him to make his own decisions. Don't make his decisions for him. He may ask for your input. That's good. Because you might have some productive input to provide, which is great. It may really help him. That's great. But don't make his decisions for him. Allow him to make his own decisions. Okay? That's all I'm saying. He loves his mother, but he does not want to date her. Okay? He don't want to date mom. He wants to date you. He really wants a partner. He doesn't want a competitor. He don't want to compete with you. Okay? But he wants someone who's going to respect him and respect who he is as a man. And these things can happen. They can happen and you can be in love and you can have a wonderful relationship with this person. And not to say that you won't have any conflict at all because things do happen. People fuck up. People do shit. But it's how you handle these situations that make the relationship work, that makes the relationship last. Okay? So I hope I said something helpful to all these women out there who are raising men... who are raising man boys. Okay? Don't be his mother. Be his partner. Okay? If you already have kids, you don't want to add this to your, you know what I'm saying, to your team. We need him to be another adult in the family. Okay? So allow him to have responsibilities and be responsible and hold him accountable for his actions. That's all I'm saying. All right? I had a lot to say. So thank you, Periscope, for joining me. Again, this video will be up on my YouTube channel, Noni, Inside with NoniAyana.com, if you want to view it. I did a lot of cursing tonight. I don't know where that's from. I think I'm just tired. I told y'all I wasn't feeling well earlier, so I'm a little, I don't know. I'm a little out of it. But this is the real me. So here it is. So anyway, I have to go. So first, I'm going to say goodbye to Periscope. Bye, y'all. And let's see. Why does this won't stop?